Hi. Guess what day it is? It's Avatar Day. Today, the new Avatar movie comes out, and a lot of people are super stoked for this movie, as am I. And I just thought I would have a little ambiance for the movie. Got the music going. I have my Mystic Martian deck, and I hope you all are able to see it, but I'm going to get going. I already lit some sage a few minutes ago, but I'm going to light it up one more time. And I have to hurry this reading along. I apologize because I have to be going to work today, and I'm wearing my Avatar sweatshirt. I don't know if you can see, but it actually glows in the dark. Like the spots and stuff glow in the dark. You can get it at Disney World if you go. They have it in the Avatar, gift shop. So not cheap though. But anyway, getting on with the reading for today. This reading is for the collective for Friday, December 16th, 2022. What do you have to show for us today? What do you need us to see? I call forth from within the light of source. Thank you for standing at the forefront. My heart and mind, thank you for activating the ancient wisdom of my soul. I welcome in the support of heaven, earth, the stars, the light beings, and beyond. And so it is. What's in store for us today? Is it going to be a magical day? The Nephilim. Controversial assessing and new perspectives. Are perhaps some of us looking at new perspectives? Controversial assessing and new perspectives. What's in store for us today or this weekend, maybe? We have the pentagram. Harmony, protection, idealism. Looks kind of cool under that light, right? Harmony, protection, and idealism. Wow, these are some heavy cards. We are accessing, we're gaining high new perspectives. Ooh, the grays. The tall grays. They are utilitarian, organized, and a bit intimidating. We going through some heavy energies? I feel like we are, because some of us are, oh my goodness, we have the Arcturians, feeling safe, wisdom keepers, and concern. Once I get all the cards, I'm going to feel out what the whole spread means, okay? Okay, we have the Andromedans. Autonomy, free will, and manifestation. Andromedans. We can manifest what we want. Do we want? What do we want? Do we want peace, harmony, or do we want chaos and disruption? You know, what do we want? Okay, I feel like... Alright, so we have the tall whites. Uncertainty, distrust, and guarded. Ooh. So there's like a duality of feelings going on here. Like, let me feel this out. I feel like some of us are dealing with a little bit of shadow work, but yet we are grounded enough to be able to assess and look at new perspectives of things, okay? And then we know that we're protected, okay? We know that there is harmony. We're able to create harmony. We understand what harmony is. Okay? And the grays, the tall grays, organized, intimidating. Sometimes we have to stand our ground. We have to stand up for what we believe. We have to not sway in our truth. Okay? Sometimes it calls for a little intimidation, not in a sense of ego, but in a sense of like, hey, your attack on me is not going to overcome my destiny. Arcturians, feeling safe, wisdom keepers and concern. The Arcturians are very much our angels in a sense. They do watch over us. They are somewhat protectors of humanity. They are the healers of humanity. They are giving us the wisdom. They are giving us the downloads we need to get through this time. We have the free will to manifest. We have the free will to manifest whatever we want, whether it's positive or negative. And that's in your control. And then the tall whites, distrust, uncertainty, guarded. That could be from, you know, your past, not being able to trust people. I know I'm actually going through some of that right now. Like, I'm I have it's hard for me to trust people that I don't know because of things that have happened to me. People abused my kindness. People walked all over me, you know, and they took my generosity for their own gain and abused it. This is why I tend to be like this. Uncertain, distrustful, guarded. I'm feeling a little bit of that right now, to be honest. So I'm not surprised this card came up. And I'm trying to work through it, okay? We're not perfect. Just because we're on this journey doesn't mean that we're always going to be perfect. You know, we're not. We're human. We're learning. We have both light and dark within us, so it's about being in the light and understanding the dark and working through the ego, understanding how it works and being able to not work against it, but not give it power. You know what I mean? All right. Wow. So please know that you are always protected. You are always being guided. And wonderful galactic family, our soul families, our light families, these beings, they're not higher than you, okay? We are just as important as they are, okay? We do not idolize extraterrestrials. You should not. They're just a little more advanced than we are. And actually, some of us are them. So, some of us are them. We're just trying to remember everything, you know? We're just trying to remember where we come from. Right now, we are the avatar in another world. Okay? We're literally, you could, like in the movie, like our higher self is, I wouldn't say sleeping, but our consciousness is very much awake. Okay? But we're inside another reality. This is exactly what happened in Avatar. His consciousness went inside an avatar being in another world, and he was completely unaware of who he really was as a human, you know? So it's almost the same concept, only it's flipped. That makes sense. Only we're human, but we're forgetting that we're an extraterrestrial. Some of us. Yeah, I mean, we're... So yeah, that's pretty much what it is, but it's just a matter of, you know, we're not to idolize any of these beings as higher than us or as gods. No, we're all the same in God's eye. We're all created equal. We all have free will. This was the will of God. So, but they are more advanced than us. So I highly suggest for you to connect to your higher self, ask for their guidance, their wisdom. They will give it to you. Meditate, 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 meditate. It's so important to meditate because that will help to open your pineal gland. That will help you connect to your higher self. That will help you connect to source. And perhaps you'll remember where you came from. All right, I love you all, and I hope you all have a beautiful weekend. If you go see the movie, enjoy it. I probably won't be able to see it till next week. It depends, because I'm kind of waiting on a friend to go see it. So, but I'm super excited. But anyways, I love you all, and I will see you soon.